Hi there. Today we are talking about business opportunities available in Kenya, in Africa, and across the globe, particularly focusing on Kenya. We're also looking on how you can be able to get finances for your business. We can't wait to see our Kenyan people creating wealth and becoming the next millionaire. We are here to talk to you, to encourage you, to talk together, to share experiences. And today, it's a special Friday because we have who is who just here next to me, Mr. Bulale.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
And feel free to ask him, to engage him, to ask us questions because we are here for you. We are here a whole 1 hour just to talk to you. And please feel free, tell somebody that we are live. Hashtag Ask Optiven. Tell everyone. And we take this opportunity to welcome our guest, Mr. Bulale, the person I value, the person I respect, the person I know that he is one of the best trainers in Africa. And I'm happy to see that he's able to partner with Optiven. And Mr. Bulale, karibu sana.
Asante.
Just welcome our customers, given that we are celebrating the Customer Service Week, the CS Week, and we are happy to have you right here in Karen, the Hub Karen.
Thank you very much, sir. Well, it's an honor that you've all joined to tune in to this broadcast. People who follow Optiven, do business with Optiven, thank you so much. And I do believe you understand. I mean, I have a very long-standing relationship with Optiven. And when I talk about customer service, I mean, I have gotten the best when I've gone to their offices. And I do understand that their foundation is of integrity. Their foundation is of thinking the customer first. And I do hope by the end of this broadcast, you'll have an ignition within yourself that will propel you to the next level, and of course do much more business, be landowners, and take your life from this level to another. You just can't be comfortable in what I call average. Normal doesn't sell anymore. We want to push you, we want to take you beyond your elastic limit so that you may achieve that which you never thought was possible.
Wow, the discussion is hashtag Ask Optiven. Please tell somebody to log in, tell somebody that Optiven, Ask Optiven is live, and we are here to talk to you, to encourage you. And maybe this particular time I'll ask our guest to advise us, because out there Kenyans are very, very hardworking. But Kenyans, we are told that every month we are registering over 200,000 startups, and people sometimes they fail. Other people, they try for 1 year, 2 years, they fail. Some of us, like myself, George Washiri, I failed 15 times. So we want to see what is this failure and what word can our guest advise our people who are trying businesses in various fields, you know, in tourism, in hotel, in stationery supply, in service industry. What can we learn from failure? Because failure is part and parcel of a journey of an entrepreneur. And maybe, I don't know your take, maybe you can advise our people, those who are doing businesses, yes, and they have tried, they have failed. What can you tell them?
I think the first thing you must understand is that failure is not final.
Mm-hmm.
And failure is a journey to success.
Uh-huh.
Nobody, I mean, we see you right now and we say, my goodness, I want to be like him. But nobody wants the 15 failure story.
Mm-hmm.
They want the now.
Yes.
But you got to understand,
uh-huh,
that failure is not finality. And also why some people don't succeed is because you open a business sometimes for the wrong reasons. Because your neighbor is selling green t-shirts,
uh-huh,
you also want to sell green t-shirts.
Wow.
You have to understand you have whatever it is in you,
uh-huh,
to do something that has never been done before. And while even if you've started something that has been done before, you got to believe in yourself. Don't do because another person has done. Their strategy may be different with your strategy, and yet it could be the same business. Could be M-Pesa.
Mm-hmm.
Could be selling land and selling land.
Uh-huh.
But you have to understand your strengths.
Uh-huh.
But the problem is sometimes your only reason for starting a business,
yes,
is to make money.
Wow.
Of course we need to make money.
Uh-huh.
But that can not be your only reason.
Interesting. Please tell us more about, I can't copy a business?
No.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you can do something that has been done because, I mean, we are relational human beings. But you cannot copy A to Z.
Mm-hmm.
Or the way Mr. George does his business.
Uh-huh.
He has 50 staff. I want 50. He drives this car. I want that car. No, you got to understand, it could be the same business, but the path is unique to you. And the problem with people is some also have given up at the second stage of failure.
Uh-huh.
You've done 15 failures. You understand?
Yes, yes.
What if you gave up on failure number 7?
you lose all the opportunity.
We would not be here today. Mm-hmm. But you have to understand, if you start business primarily to make money, there's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Money is important, but you also are giving solutions mm-hmm. to a problem.
Yes.
You know, people want land. You are a solution provider. The moment you have passion,
mm-hmm.
it takes you to a professionalism,
yes.
which will take you to your profit.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So
yes.
when you do something out of passion,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yes.
I maybe don't have a passion of selling land.
Mm-hmm.
You have a passion of selling land.
Yes.
I'm a speaker.
Uh-huh.
My passion for speaking will inevitably take me to professionalism,
mm-hmm.
and professionalism inevitably will take me to my profit.
You are right.
So please, I want you to understand,
mm-hmm.
maybe right now you're thinking of giving up. And you know very well from the depths of your heart, that is what you're supposed to do. Well, you have a gentleman here who is known all over the country and beyond, who is telling you, before I got where I got,
uh-huh.
I failed 15 times.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you giving up and you only failed once?
I can see people are sending questions and we are going to answer all your questions today. We have a whole 1 hour. Please feel free to send those questions. Regardless of where you are, you can be able to send to us. And we are here. We are actually reading all the questions you can be able to send to us on Facebook, Optiven Limited. You can go to our YouTube, Optiven Kenya. You can like it. And let me tell you, we are here for you. We have dedicated this 1 hour purposely for you to tell you that you may fail today, but that does not determine your destiny tomorrow. Because people who fail, it's a lesson. Personally, I failed so many times, and I can guarantee you, don't just give up. Just as we are told here that we have opportunities, zillions of opportunities, and later on in the discussion, we'll be able to discuss what are the real business opportunities available in our nation, Kenya, in Africa, that our people, 48 million people, can be able to pick it up and move, because the people to change this nation is you and me. And I can tell you, today is the day we are discussing with you on what you can be able to do. But before I go very far, I can read one question somebody's asking me. Please tell us, if I fail 5-6 times, do I continue the same business idea? Maybe you can elaborate on that.
Well, even if you fail 10 times, let me tell you, as long as you know you're doing that which you're born to do,
mm-hmm.
let me tell you, there'll be obstacles. If you're going from Nairobi to Mombasa, for example, you will find bumps, you'll find potholes.
Uh-huh.
But it doesn't say you have to stop your journey.
Mm-hmm.
You just need to know how to navigate through that journey called business. And in due time, you will get to your destination.
Wow.
I mean, most of the successful people we see all over the world, if you got their insight on how many times they failed,
uh-huh.
I'm telling you, it will give you the oomph and the fortitude to fight another day. And also one thing you have to understand
uh-huh.
is that, like right now, you say you failed 6 times. Ask yourself,
mm-hmm.
who is around you?
Wow.
Sometimes you need people who will give you the morale to fight another day.
Oh, yes.
But the problem is, some people hang around people who tell them,
uh-huh.
oh, forget it.
Mm-hmm.
Give up.
Yes.
Somebody once said, if you hang around 4 millionaires,
uh-huh.
you probably will be the 5th millionaire.
I like that.
What if you hang around 4 fools?
You'll be the 5th fool.
You'll be the 5th fool. Exceedingly abundantly above all you could think, ask or imagine.
Yes.
So you hang around the people who will see something mm. in you
mm-hmm.
that has not really come out,
mm-hmm.
but it's a flicker of light.
That means what you're saying is that for you to fail and to come and succeed, the people you associate with is very important.
Oh, wow. Lend me your ears.
Uh-huh.
I will control where you're going.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Wow, I can see another question here from Victor is asking, I have failed over 7 times. Am I doing the right thing?
You probably are doing the right
uh-huh.
thing. I mean, unless you're murdering people and you fail to shoot them 7 times.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're doing a legit business, let me tell you something. Just keep on pushing.
Wow.
Keep on pushing. Uh-huh. And one time,
uh-huh.
you will see to where Mr. George is sitting
mm-hmm.
and saying, I failed 9 times and look where I am. Because, I mean, I'm thinking, let's think about mm-hmm. this for a minute.
Yes.
If you had given up,
uh-huh.
it means there are people who would not have been employed.
You're right. Opportunities lost.
Yes.
You're right.
Remember,
mm-hmm.
whatever you are called to do is not for you.
Uh-huh.
It is for other people.
I agree.
You may employ one person today,
mm-hmm.
but let me tell you, if you keep on moving on,
uh-huh.
you'll employ 100 people.
Wow.
And 100 people, you'll feed 1,000 mouths.
Mm-hmm.
So please remember, every time you feel like giving up, think about the people who you have met
wow.
and others who you have not yet met,
mm-hmm.
but are waiting for you to succeed for them to be in employment.
Somebody called Kibef all the way from Australia is asking, George and Mr. Bulale, how can I identify the right opportunity for me, not for my friends,
okay.
but for me, the right opportunity for either business, the right opportunity for career, for me without failing like you, George Washiri?
Okay, now that's a very good question. Many people are at a place of confusion and perambulating in failure and all that because you start something that you're not sure about.
Yes.
Now, how do you know you're called to do something? The first thing you must understand, that thing that you can do for free. Mr. George wants people empowered.
Oh, yes.
He wants people owning properties. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's his passion. He wants to see you empowered. I mean, if there's something that you can do for free, that is towards your passion.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing is the thing that annoys you most.
Yes.
You don't like people littering.
Uh-huh.
Meaning you like cleanliness.
Yes.
You must have a cleaning business.
Wow.
You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You the thing that annoys you and vexes you and you want to make it right, that is what you're called to do. That, I mean, talent, as I said this on Monday, talent is what you are paid for.
Wow. Talent is what you are paid for. I like that.
Calling or passion is what you are made for.
Amazing.
So if you do that which you are made for, inevitably, you'll be paid to do it. You'll be paid to do it.
I like what you are saying. And somebody called Mr. Mugo Munene. Tuko Dani. Dani.
Dani kabisa.
So tell somebody, hashtag Ask Optiven. Let me tell you, we are here to share information for free. I think you are good with the people identifying opportunities. And like you are saying that, identify your passion, do it. And I tell people that never ever do business for money. What happens when you get the money? Would you stop doing business?
And then there's also something called market segmentation.
Uh-huh.
Now, for example, you cannot come to Luya Land, where I come from, and say you want to have chicken but not for sale. We'll eat it. So, I mean, market segmentation.
Uh-huh.
If you want to sell chicken, for example, the best place to sell chicken is where there are Luyas.
Wow.
You understand what I'm saying?
I understand.
Understand your market, and once you go to your market, it will respond to you. Once it responds to you, it takes you to another level. You understand what I'm saying? Now, like for example, you want to buy land in Kitengela. You want to buy land in Athi River.
Yes.
You will go there.
Wow.
Because you know that is a place where people want to buy property.
Mm-hmm.
So understand your market.
Wow.
And then move forward without looking back.
That
and
means opportunities are all over.
They're all over.
There are zillions of opportunities.
But there are people who are sitting next to opportunities, but they don't know it's an opportunity.
Oh my goodness.
Because you want your opportunity to come in a big way.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes the opportunity comes in a whisper.
Wow.
While you're driving, while you're walking, you will see something and you hear that voice that says, this is a problem and you are the solution.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Somebody told me a story that opportunities are all over. And they told me yesterday, you know, O means opportunity.
Yes.
O means opportunity. Yesterday, there's no O. So yesterday is gone.
Yes.
It's finished. Today, there's one O. There's an opportunity. Tomorrow, there are three O's. Three solid opportunities.
Fantastic.
Please don't just sit there waiting. Think of something that you can do. Think of a solution. There's another young man that I really, really love. The other day, we have some challenges in Kenya where people are going to streets.
Yes.
And the guy is was supplying water. And the water was costing 70 shillings per bottle for people not to be harmed by the tear gas. Can you imagine this young man identifying opportunities out of trouble? And that's how we identify opportunities.
See? That is how looking at a chance and you grab your opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Someone else would have gone to sell tomato sauce. Or chili sauce. No, where there is tear gas, you need water. So check your opportunity, jump on it, and move on.
I think the next thing we are going to share today is business opportunities available across Kenya, in the counties, in Africa, globally. Are there still opportunities? And maybe I can give you a chance just to tell them, what can they do? How can they identify those opportunities? What are they?
Now, for example, we are seated in a very beautiful place, Artificial Lake.
Uh-huh.
I would expect a good photographer to come and talk to the management of the hub and say, I would like to use this site to take photos.
My goodness, opportunity number one.
That's an opportunity. I would like to use this site.
Yes.
Can it be a wedding site? You can charge me a small cover charge, but allow me to come and be taking photos here. There are lovebirds, there are people who are engaged every day. So that's an opportunity.
Wow.
And you could be abroad and maybe you're Kenyan and you're thinking, what could I do?
Mm-hmm.
You have financial elasticity.
Mm-hmm.
This is when you talk to people and say, I want to buy land back home.
Yes.
That's a business opportunity because
Fantastic.
I'll tell you something about land.
Mm-hmm.
It always appreciates.
You are right.
Put some money,
mm-hmm.
buy some land.
Uh-huh.
In 5 years,
wow.
you will come here and be the biggest landowner. That is an opportunity. Mm-hmm. But the problem is, we are looking for opportunities to come in a very loud way. It's mm-hmm. not going to happen. You have to have the third eye uh-huh. that sees that which many are not seeing. Mm-hmm. And that is how comes some people stand out.
Yes.
And I can agree with you, because if you look at Kenya today, our population is increasing. Today, according to the United Nations statistics, they are saying we are approximately 48 million people. These people, you look at the hospitality industry, these guys must eat. Actually, after this show, we are going to the Eagle Peak Spa behind us to eat. That means these are opportunities available yes. for us. Look at the counties, Mr. Burari, and the people who are watching us. If you go to the counties today, there are zillions of opportunities, but we have refused to go and talk to the governors, to talk to the government in the counties. We are only focusing our eyes in the city.
In fact, we call that in training the curse of the big city.
Mm-hmm.
You want to be in Nairobi.
Yes.
Sometimes the money is in Kakamega.
You are right.
It's in Kiambu. Mm-hmm. So what, like as a trainer,
yes.
what I'm going to do, I'm talking to governors all over the country.
Mm-hmm.
If I have to go to Moyale, I will go to Moyale
yes.
to train those people. Mm-hmm. So the curse of the big city is what is making people take one step forward and 10 steps back.
Wow.
You go to spread your wings, go to places that people have never been.
Mm-hmm.
And let me tell you, the opportunities are there. In fact, let me say this to you, and you got to write this down.
Yes.
Opportunity is knocking on your doors.
Mm.
The problem is many have refused to open the door.
Wow.
Mahenia Sam is asking, I'm an entrepreneur. No, he's asking, employment or entrepreneurship? Which is better? Hey, I like that. Employment or entrepreneurship?
A tricky question.
Go ahead.
I mean, people must be employed.
Uh-huh.
But even entrepreneurs were one time employed.
I was for 10 years.
Exactly.
Yes.
And you got to go through the stage.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes, even when a newborn is, when a baby is born, there's the crawling, then there's the walking, and then there's the running.
Yes.
Some people are called to be employed
mm-hmm.
because you have it in you to support
wow.
somebody's vision.
Mm-hmm.
But other people must be brave enough to go into the virgin waters of entrepreneurship.
You're right.
You could be the first person in your family to go into entrepreneurship. Because if you are confident enough to trailblaze,
mm-hmm.
then you have the grace to be an entrepreneur.
Wow.
But I'm not telling people now, this afternoon after lunch, you go write your resignation letters, you will suffer. So those who are supposed to be employed,
mm-hmm.
you catch the vision of the visionary and take it to another level. But both are good
yes.
with its pros and cons.
You're right.
Yes.
Actually, you're right, because for me, I value employment the same way I value entrepreneurship.
Absolutely.
Look at Kenya today. We have people we saw in the newspaper earning 37 million a month. I don't what? Get that kind of money. We have people earning 9 million a month. So you can be in career and you earn the six figure you are looking for. You can be in entrepreneurship. You don't find that kind of money. So
yes.
as you said, both entrepreneurship and employment is important. Personally, I worked for 10 years. When you're working, you get networks, you know people.
Yes.
So don't feel that you are in the wrong place if you're working for somebody. Who knows, the next 20 years, you'll be having your own business, and both, actually, they are very, very important.
And you could be in employment, uh-huh. and you know very well that you're moving towards entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
That is fine. Don't resign haphazardly.
Uh-huh.
What you got to do, consolidate some funds, get networks,
wow.
because your net worth is in your network.
You are right.
Then at the right time,
mm-hmm.
you can slide off smoothly
wow.
into entrepreneurship.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much. I can see so many questions, people logging in, and I'm so happy to see the popularity of this hashtag AskOptiven
yes.
because we are giving out what we can. And as you know, Optiven has been a award-winning company.
Absolutely.
This year alone, we won Super Brand. We were voted number one company in land selling across East Africa. On real estate, we are number four in real estate, and we thank God for the support that our customers have given us. If you're wondering, who are these fellows called OptiVen? Go to our website on www.optiven.co.ke. You can be able to find what is happening right there.
But I also want to talk to somebody who maybe you had, you didn't grow up in affluence.
Uh-huh.
It's also another problem.
Yes.
Where you think entrepreneurship or success in business is the preserve of the people who grew up in the upmarket areas.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely not. They can take away your car. They can take away your house. They can take away your clothes. They can take away your perfumes, even your phone.
Wow.
But there's something nobody can take away from you.
Mm-hmm.
Is the power to dream.
My goodness, power to dream. I like that.
Yeah. Take away your 5x6 queen size bed.
Yes.
But let me tell you, you can sit on a rock of the pavement by the streets, but your power to dream and to have a vision, nobody can take away from you.
Wow.
So you got to get up with that power, with that vision, and say, I may not be there right now, but the vision will drive me to where I want to be.
Power to dream.
Yes.
Somebody from Eldoret, Mr. Joseph, is asking, George, can you tell us how you spend your day?
Yes.
That's a tough one. Of course.
But I know you start very early.
By 4, I'm up.
Today we were chatting at 4 a.m. Now, you cannot sleep on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday and expect success on Sunday.
You're right.
It's not going to happen.
You're right.
And for the sake of Joseph, as Bolale said, by 4 a.m., I don't need an alarm clock. I am up. You spend the first 6 minutes thinking about how the day will look like. You visualize about the day. The next 15 minutes is prayer. The next 15 minutes, I read my Bible. Another 30 minutes is reading. I'm reading a book by Clifford Dollar. Wonderful book, The 8 Steps of Success.
Fantastic.
A very good book. And after that, I take 30 minutes to exercise. And then I'm ready to take breakfast and go to work and serve the people, serve the Kenyan people, and serve Optiven. Because I am a servant at Optiven. So, Joseph, please. If you are sleeping up to 6, tupa your blanket. We are on the move. And somebody is asking me, George, are there other opportunities available, especially in Kenya?
Oh, there are very many opportunities.
Uh-huh.
But the problem is, we don't chase the opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you something. You have to knock on the doors. You have to send job applications.
Mm-hmm.
They'll reject you 5 times.
Uh-huh.
Send another 15 times.
Yes.
You got to keep on knocking. Mm-hmm. You know, resistance.
Yes.
Or persistence
mm-hmm.
wears out resistance.
You're right.
You got to keep on knocking on that
mm-hmm.
door. At some point, the wall of Jericho will come down,
uh-huh.
and because the success is on the other side of the wall of Jericho,
yes.
it's up to you to keep on knocking until the wall comes.
I have a blog called www.georgeyoshi.com. You see all those opportunities available there, and I educate people on what you can do with 1,000, what you can do with 5,000, what you can do with 50,000, and let me tell you, not just stay at home. Do something, create work, create something. Don't just stay there, especially for graduates.
Yes.
You know, team up with people.
Absolutely.
Just do something. And I can tell you, there's a lot of things to be done. Look at online. Maybe you can tell them about opportunities available online.
And that is why also online, you have to be very careful.
Uh-huh.
If I come on your social media and I want to give you an opportunity, I will press to some of the photos that you have.
Uh-huh.
And if I'm seeing you, hashtag shisha, hashtag nightclub,
oh
hashtag follow the leader, I'm telling you, I'll frown upon you.
Yes.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So be extremely careful what you're doing on social media because internet never forgets.
Oh, yes.
And also in social media, I mean, if you do the right things and you have a big followership,
mm-hmm.
that's an opportunity to promote other businesses.
Yes.
You can write Mr. Waishuri a proposal and say, I want to help you promote your business.
Mm-hmm.
For this amount, I will post on my social media.
Wow.
And he'll ask you, why should I pay you?
Mm-hmm.
And you'll say, I have 150,000 people who follow me on social media.
Mm-hmm.
And 70% are big spenders. So that is a way of advertising.
Uh-huh.
You've got to create social media has brought down the borders.
Yes.
It is a borderless.
Wow,
place,
you
right, understand?
Yes, yeah.
And you can do business in America without a visa because you're doing it from social media.
I like that.
And that's a comfort of your own home,
mm-hmm.
you know, with your bundles and a good phone.
Yes.
And there are ways people can pay.
Mm-hmm.
There's PayPal.
Wow.
There's even M-Pesa through Wave that they send you your money.
Uh-huh.
But the problem is we are looking for something tangible.
Uh-huh.
Let me tell you, your future is not outside you.
I tell you.
Your future is within you.
Mm-hmm.
It's up to you to see it through the eyes of vision.
Wow, I like that.
Yes.
Maybe you can share with our people on how they can be able to generate finances to finance their businesses. You know, somebody says, George, I have an opportunity, I have an idea. Where do I get the money from?
Now, the problem is sometimes when you have an idea and you come to somebody who is willing to finance, because there are many people who are willing to finance, but they ask you, what is your short-term plan?
Mm-hmm.
What is your mid-term plan? What is your long-term plan? And you have nothing.
You're right.
An idea well orchestrated or well written and explained,
mm-hmm.
you will get finances from people.
Yes.
There are so many people. I have friends who are looking for people to finance.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is that when they ask people,
yes.
so what do you want to do?
Uh-huh.
They're like, I know I can sing.
Yes.
Then, where do you see yourself in 2 years from now?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know yet.
Yes.
I will not finance that kind of
person.
That's what people tell me.
Yes.
You understand? I was in a meeting somewhere,
mm-hmm.
and one of our great, I can't mention his name, but he asked some people, how many of you have ideas here?
Mm-hmm.
And they were young people.
Yes.
And he says, all of you come in front. And some of them started talking.
Wow.
And halfway,
mm.
you tell them, Gerald, sit down, sit down. There was nothing.
Yes.
But someone comes and says, I have this,
mm-hmm.
I can do this.
Yes.
In 5 years, I have seen what happens, and this is where I think we'll be. that kind of person you'll finance.
I think you're right. And also, as we think of this business, it's important for us to develop relationship. Relationship with your families, because you may have an idea and you want to borrow this money from family members.
Yes.
It's important for you when you borrow money, please pay.
Yes.
Because the person you are borrowing and you don't pay, next time you are in need, you may go to the same people, they will not give you.
Absolutely.
If you borrow money from the bank, please pay. Today we have CRB. If your name appears on CRB, it means you cannot access money.
Absolutely.
And for us, I deal with a lot of young people who want to start their own businesses. And one of the challenges is trust. You did something, you borrowed 100,000, you never paid, and so the bank cannot trust you.
Absolutely.
So if you're out there looking for finances, even the SACCO, because some people borrow money from SACCOs. So once you are guaranteed somebody or you pick money, please pay that money, because you never know, tomorrow you may require those finances.
But
because many people, Mr. Burare, want to see George Washiri today. They don't know we have walked a journey for 18 years, you know, failing 15 times. Let me advise you, people who are doing business. It's important for you to start poorly, poorly, step by step, because success does not come overnight.
But that's the problem with the young people right now, Mr. George.
Uh-huh.
We are looking for what I call microwave success.
Mm-hmm.
If you're looking for microwave success, the only thing you'll do is warm your meal.
Yes.
But you'll never have sustainable wealth.
Mm-hmm.
And every time, remember, every time you do something,
uh-huh,
don't be selfish. It is not for you.
You're right.
It's for other people, like you have employed people.
Yes.
So there are people you have not met,
mm-hmm,
but you have imparted them.
Yes.
Somebody who works for you,
mm-hmm,
is paying school fees for their children.
Yes.
Thanks to,
mm-hmm,
Optimum. You,
yes,
understand?
Yeah.
So everything you venture into, always remember it's for the greater good.
You're right.
Beyond you,
mm-hmm,
beyond your family alone.
Uh-huh.
You must carry the weight of other people.
Mm-hmm.
But remember, passion,
wow,
will take you to your professionalism.
Wow.
And your professionalism,
mm-hmm,
will take you to your profit.
For us at Optiven, we are located at Barclays Plaza, 14th floor. Today, we want to thank the management of Karen Hub. This is one of the best hubs.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, the best mall I've ever seen.
Good place to come and relax and shop.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Absolutely.
So, if you are there, you'll never visit the Hub, Karen. You better know places. This place is beautiful. You experience the peace of mind. And where to eat? We have one of the best restaurants. It's called the Eagle Peak Spa. Today, they gave me some water. Some dawa, and you can be able to come and taste the pork.
Let me tell you, I've eaten that place, eh?
Yes.
I've come there with my friends. That place has good food.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic service.
Wonderful.
You even enjoy eating your food.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, please.
Mm-hmm.
All I will tell you right now, I hope you have inculcated within you what you have had today. It would be useless to hear and not make a move. So today, look at yourself in the mirror and say, this is the beginning of the rest of my life. Look at the future and tell the future, I am coming after you.
Wow, wow. I think we have to conclude there. And thank you very much, all the people who are online. We value you, we honor you, we respect you. See you on Friday. Please tell somebody that hashtag AskOptiven. We are live on Friday and we value, we honor, we respect you. And for me, it's to thank my guest. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Personally, I really, really respect you. I value
you.
God
thank
bless you.
So
thank you.
So much.
And God bless you.
Thank you.